Plagiarism and copying has always had a presence in art and has evolved according to the ever-changing exhibition and creation of art. From students in the Louvre studying and copying its collection in 1793 to evidence of Degas taking heavy inspiration from other artists, copying has been referred to as a tradition. Social media platforms such as Instagram allows for a mass following. However, due to copyright guidelines and the increased availability of artwork, there is a heightened chance of work being copied. But what is the difference between appropriation and plagiarism? Appropriation uses pre-existing objects or images with little or no transformation applied to them. Appropriation has always been relevant in art. For example, Andy Warhol's Campbell's Soup Can, 1961. When does appropriation go too far is a question that looks at the borderline between appropriation and plagiarism and encapsulates a series showcased by Richard Price, who compiled a series of blown-up photos taken from his Instagram feed. The series includes a variety of Instagram personalities and is titled New Portraits. Price removed the original captions and comments and exhibited them and began selling them for $100,000 each. Companies have also taken strong inspiration from Instagram artists. In this instance, the artist and company came to an agreement and the artist has used this as an example for artists to support each other and maintain artistic integrity. Further, mass communication over major social media platforms allows for a wider audience and thus a rise in others taking inspiration and using it in a way that can erase or appropriate the original work. Ultimately, a practice in art making, which begs the question, is anything purely original? And if everyone is an artist, then what is the line between art and the everyday? Is art appropriation of the real life? Art was traditionally something that has cultural, symbolic value or even just economical value and had a concentrated, clear-cut identity where concepts like the artist's processes, the critics, or the historical context are considered less important to the object of art. Art exists to reach and eventually involve the public, such as the performance works of Milo Moire or the viral sensation Lil Miquela. Creating and consuming art is done so in relation to mass communication. Here, art loses its specific identities and no longer needs to fulfill any traditional roles of having cultural or symbolic value or message and instead can be playful. Despite being streamlined into a focus on quickly reaching the audience, mass communication has helped artists and art consumers, specifically with social media. Yayoi Kusama's Infinity Mirrors is one that fully utilized the advantages of mass communication. Through social media, a viral excitement was generated for the exhibit in a way traditional advertising could not. The majority of tickets to the exhibit were sold online, and the entire exhibit itself was one that was heavily documented through the social media of its visitors. The instantaneous gratification of mass communication and the bite-sized consumption of information, there is a risk of a shallow engagement and creation with art. Being an artist in the modern world has its challenges. For instance, through social media, gimmicky art such as paint pouring or landscape spray painting art have flooded the art market with quick and aesthetically pleasing works that can be quickly replicated and sold at cheap prices. The use of mass communication through social media can aid the process of having your work acknowledged and recognized by people worldwide. Philosopher Martin Heidegger declares that in being physically hung in a gallery, a work of art merely becomes an object of the industry and is no longer experienced in and of itself as an artwork. With the always-present online gallery, our work is freed from becoming a mere object of the industry. One artist in particular that strategically utilizes Instagram as a platform to rapidly spread their work is Banksy. Instagram allows Banksy to stay anonymous to the public eye. So the focus is driven further toward the online presence of the work itself. Passion is the impetus to a piece of art and can be defined as a strong and barely controllable emotion. Australian-raised artist C.J. Hendry twice withdrew from university, the second time in order to pursue a life in art, quote, "I love this thing that I do, hashtag college dropout," unquote. Passion does not require complete understanding, just complete dedication. Comparison is not a matter of determining whose is better, but rather of analyzing the unique qualities that distinguish the two from each other. In a world of mass production, mass communication, and mass consumption, people don't need more of the same thing. What society needs is something and someone authentic. Comparison is the combination of seeking and finding, giving and taking, and observing and ignoring. Remember, two unlike things cannot be measured by the same scales, and it is this that often blurs the sight of one when measuring themselves. There are two types of failures to consider as an artist. The first is failing to distinguish your own style. The second is almost imperative for great art, and that is failure found in the trying and testing of things. In order to cope as an artist, you must first realize things don't always work, but it is in these failures that you must delve into in order to discover what makes your art great art.